I don't understand why you would want a shoe where you could pull it apart. All right, it is the Yak Friday. Roan and Big Cat are going to West Virginia. Nikki T is a sick boy. Yeah. A sick little boy.
I'll be damned.
Sucks.
Yeah, it does suck. Rudy's in here with us. Hi, Rudy.
Hello. Thanks for having me.
Rudy.
Sass?
Is this your first appearance?
No, I did one a while ago. You brought me in
post serious?
No. I did one a while ago.
You did. I remember when Rio was talking about eating cum.
Right.
Yes.
Yeah.
He was on one of the more uncomfortable ones.
She was rhapsodizing about eating semen. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, she was just
not eating it, for just housing it for a second.
She was talking about
spitting it back in the guy's face,
regurgitating it.
Yeah. Would you?
So you couldn't be more wrong.
I was very wrong. Thank you, Owen.
She was talking recycling.
Uh huh.
She is a very responsible person. Mm-hmm. Hey, Sass, is this the first time the hair's been out?
Yeah.
My head.
Oh.
Doesn't look that bad.
What do you mean your head? Your head hurts?
Oh, well, me and Owen both have COVID.
Really?
Really?
Big time.
Why are you?
Should hear the noises coming from the apartment right now.
What?
Owen, your color isn't great today, if I'm being honest.
What?
Yeah.
You're very pale.
Yeah, you said you were sick too. Everyone's sick.
Yeah.
You said you were sick.
I don't like that.
I heard KB wasn't going to be here.
But mine's not contagious. I had a migraine.
Yeah, I'm not going to admit that on radio. Like, this is like we're in a time where you can't just say you're sick.
Right.
But I
You can't say you're sick if it's just a migraine.
No, there's no such thing as just a migraine. That's sick.
I know a migraine's bad, but like when you say you're sick, like I'm not thinking a migraine. I'm thinking like, oh, you have COVID.
This shit is depressing. TJ, you're the real star here. Hey. What a night for you.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Everyone saw the video.
You want to run it back?
Not to be overshadowed by Dave's recent quote tweet, but
yeah, whatever.
No, I think that was a good sign for you. But
I didn't see Dave's recent quote tweet. That happened very recently.
He acknowledged it, which is a win for TJ.
Can we just run the video back real quick?
Yeah, run the video back.
Yeah, it's a very funny video.
It's an amazing video.
So was that I was last night?
Yeah.
Get it off, Ron.
Rutgers fucking wins.
TJ, so what happens directly after this? What's the scenes? Give us a
It was like a mosh pit on the court for like 20 minutes probably.
And then once you guys make your way out of the arena, is there couch burns?
No, we head back to...
Did you do anything crazy? Did you rob a Juul charity concert?
Head back to College Ave, hit up Are You Hungry, get a sandwich with a bunch of shit in it. And
Are You Hungry?
Yep.
That's a great restaurant name.
They do sandwiches with like... cheesesteak, chicken fingers, mozzarella sticks, french fries, hot sauce on it.
No, but you could tell TJ stayed for a very long time because he took an empty court picture after all that.
Yeah, how long were you there after the
I probably stayed at the arena for like 30 minutes after the game ended, and then in the parking lot doing social stuff for like a half hour.
Nice.
It smells like a Great American Cookie Company in here.
It's my coffee. It's donut shop.
Is it?
Donut shop coffee.
It smells delicious.
I know. It doesn't. No, it's okay.
It smells of vanilla and love.
Do you ever feel like when coffee smells too good though, it doesn't taste as good?
I don't really drink coffee or regard. Yeah. I don't regard the smell of it at all. Usually, I just dive in.
Yeah, it's a good smell.
Do you like
TJ? That was the biggest win of your fandom fan career.
That was the biggest win in school
in
history.
in any sport.
Not probably.
No.
It's top two wins in school history in any sport.
No.
definitely in your life.
Definitely behind the one you had on that
Thursday
Brandon,
night. Why don't you sit this one out because I'm talking to the people who have won big games. Rudy, you won a D1 national title in hockey.
I did. Guilty.
And what was the – what did you got? How did you celebrate?
We went.
Because, all right, so I'm going to – then we're going to go to me because my team won the MAC East Championship.
So what's the order after that?
And then it's over.
Yeah. Yeah. We just went and got fucked up like real Americans.
Where did you win it at? Which city?
Chicago.
Alex Cooper said when BU won, they were fucking on the ice. Did you do that?
No.
What?
BU.
She said first BU off, men's hockey won.
Was, did they she were go to BU?
Were they fucking each other?
I didn't know that.
That could not have happened.
Who fucked? Yeah, what do you mean they fucked on the ice?
There was just an orgy
who
on the ice.
Who was fucking on the ice?
You want to pull up the clip?
Do hockey players fuck on the ice?
I've never seen
that
it.
That doesn't seem
that's
like...
That's got to be like, you got to get some, like... It's got to hurt, right?
Yeah, that can't feel good. Fun.
Dude, ice hurts.
Both in surface and temperature. Yeah, everything about ice is unpleasant.
Your skin, like, up against just
so
the
you've
ice.
Never fucked on ice?
Never fucked on ice. No, never Bro. Fucked. Never. I've never lived like that.
Is it a good idea for
I
you?
Fucked in ice.
Did you?
In school suspension, yeah. I was one of... Well... There was a lot of people who did, so I wasn't like.
Wait, do you mean like the detention, like the
ice is ice, in school suspension? Yeah.
Damn, and you fucked or you got fucked?
Yeah, did you?
what is? Is there a difference?
Oh, there's a big.
Wait, there, yeah. there was an investigation. Now, sex in the penalty box is a lot different than fucking on the ice. In the penalty
Still
box, that makes sense.
Hard to do, right?
I mean, that
no,
kind of.
I would think
is
that's
it after
just,
hours.
It's just a bench.
Yeah, but it's also kind of genius because it's like it's where bad boys go, so it's kind of a loophole. You know what I mean? It's like international waters. Yeah, that's some wild boy shit. No, we didn't do that. We didn't do any
you
of that.
You just went out and got fucked up.
We just went and got fucked up. I walked home after we went out, and I just walked home solo. And one of my, like, weird drunk traits is I like getting, like, fucked up in a city I've never been and then just finding my way home and just wandering.
That is a remarkably dangerous
It's so
mindset.
Dumb. But I like to test my sense of direction because I feel like I have a good sense of direction. I did it in Myrtle Beach. By accident one time, but then that one, it was actually really nice though. I'd walked, it was like a cool moment just to be by myself and just walking through Chicago, just like
what?
We did it.
You like doing that, Kyle?
By yourself?
Yeah, it's just solo. Yeah, yeah, just solo walking home.
Nine Fuck drinks up. Deep, I'm gonna test my sense of direction in the strange
yeah,
city
dude.
I've never
been.
It's
like
been.
Playing on legendary difficulty. Yeah, yeah, it was fun though. I mean, it's cool. Chicago's a good city to win it in. For sure, because it's a lot
yeah,
of fun.
It's a big,
I think that's enough.
City,
that's
yeah.
enough of that. Tell me about winning the MAC.
I won
yeah,
my,
let's talk
yeah
MAC.
We won ours in Mount Pleasant, Michigan. We clinched it after a dual win in against Central Michigan. I wasn't starting.
Oh, I didn't.
I wasn't there either. I was because they if you weren't starting, you're not going to travel to an away duel. So yeah, we went to the loft. I got a couple Hulks.
What's that? Is that a kind of drink?
Yeah, it's like a
what are those
a mountain.
Yeah.
There might be like some. It's green.
Yeah, giant.
It's like a novelty scam where there's probably like this much liquor and then a bunch of green shit, and you chug it with your friends.
We had a drink called Hypnotic. Well, it was Hypnotic and Hennessy, and that was we called that the Hulk back in 2002.
Oof.
I thought you were racist.
Huh? Very much no, brother. Very much no. The drunkest I ever got was me and my guys going to a strip club. In Memphis. Okay, anyway.
When's the last time you've been loopy fucked up?
2007.
Really?
Yeah, 2007 was the last time I got drunk.
Do you miss it?
Not really.
Because you could probably acquire that.
Did you just never like it?
It just never stuck with me. Like, I could do it and then just not have the desire to do it again.
Yeah.
So that was very good for me. But 2007, my cousin Anna's
well,
wedding.
Cool.
When Anna and Drew got married, I got fucked up.
Was it fun?
I'm sure it was, yeah. It's the only time in my 16 years now of being with my wife where I've ever been in a car that she drove. I drive 100% of the time.
That's how it should be.
Right.
Yeah. Women in the back, men in the front.
I drive 100% of the time, but she drove that night, and that was one of the reasons I said, well, I'm not doing this again.
That's the only reason.
You got sober right. because your wife's driving?
Deep-seated misogyny is right. the only reason that's
not really,
you.
Not really got sober. I just didn't ever want to ride in the passenger seat again. I don't like riding in the passenger seat, period.
But you
I
were never either. Like yeah. not. You were never like. You never like had like a problem, right?
No.
Yeah,
no, I've probably been drunk. 15 to 20
yeah,
times in my
life.
Yeah,
that's what I thought.
Yeah, not much at all.
You're more of a Molly guy.
Huge Molly guy, yeah. yes. Gigantic.
Yeah, it's the you try it once.
Okay, let's try
yeah,
it.
Maybe you'll connect with your kids.
Yeah, a spiritual awakening. You should do some candy flipping. You ever heard of that? Yeah.
No, I haven't. What's candy flipping?
Candy flipping is when you do acid and Molly.
See, I wouldn't even know how to acquire the goods to do that or even where to start.
You would get acid and Molly.
No, I understand that. I how would you do the Molly first or the acid first?
I've never done it.
No.
You want to talk about playing on legendary difficulty. That is the black that's a double black diamond of Drew and drugs. It's a lot, I bet.
When's the last time you've
that
been?
Just like doesn't sound
you
fun
weed
though
recently.
March. Yeah, March. March Madness I smoked weed with Ronan then. But that doesn't
I was there. What the fuck?
You were there?
I was in there. I was
burning. Did Ron pressure you into doing it?
I was burning with the boys.
No, I we just, you know, Rome was going outside. I was like, can I do it? And I did. So.
I was stoked that you were with us. That
and
was
I,
cool.
And I did it, but then the next 2 hours we were on stream, I said zero words and thought I couldn't shut up.
Oh, yeah.
But you were also battling. I remember that. You were battling migraines. You had the sunglasses on.
I had the migraine the day before, so I was my body was already like it is now. My body's just not where it needs to be.
Right.
But I was trying to get $10,000. I was in that $10,000 competition.
Right.
And we had to do our picks, and it was me and White Sox Dave. That's already a handicap because he's fucking stupid.
Right.
So I got high, and then I just wrote down all the picks, and I had him deliver them, and it worked out. We won.
Oh, you guys! I forgot you guys won.
Yeah, we won. Yeah.
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 When you guys got
the Bitcoin?
Picks?
No, that was a different one. That I just won the $50,000 crypto, but I don't know if I'm going to get it. So we'll see. There I am. That was during that moment. Yeah.
Dude, you look
damn,
good.
You look, yeah, you look happy.
Yeah,
I was happy. I was very happy.
Yeah, dude. That dude's.
Where's your mouth, dude? Twisted. Dog, the fuck?
It was in there somewhere,
where his
man.
Lips go?
I don't know. It was. I was just living the life at that point.
That looks like one of those awesome. Commercials from like Middle America where some dude's selling mattresses.
Yeah. Or really bad used cars.
Yeah.
What were you saying, Kyle?
What was I saying?
National championship.
Oh, you guys deliver your picks,
right?
And then you always give an explanation as why, like you're right. picking. Is it tough to do that when you're like your career record is a losing record?
Well, mine isn't a losing record
because, like, you know, like everything you say has zero merit or
correct.
Value, and you're expecting your audience to like take that.
Gambling on games is legitimately. I mean, you can have every reason in the world that you think you have, and none of it matters at all. None of it matters at all.
You give the explanation for your pick in a serious manner.
I do, personally, yes. And then it just turns out wrong.
I would respect somebody who was just like, I'm guessing. This is my guess.
That's my thing.
Let's
I think
guess
there should
on
be
the same
a gambler
side.
Who
I don't
just acknowledges his...
Well, Marty's close to that. I mean, Marty will say, oh, I like the color of this uniform better, so I'm doing that. And that's,
Glennie does that.
He's going to bet the same bet over and over and over.
He just bets overs of whatever game
he's
watching.
And I can't do that, which it works for them. It doesn't work for me.
You still try to, like, yeah.
Say, there you go. I'm
persuade people.
That's not bad.
I made, what's that, 1,400 bets this year, and I'm down two.
That's a pretty remarkable feat, actually.
Yeah.
This is my first year really gambling, and I found that it works a lot better when you just let God deal with it. You don't think.
Correct. Mm-hmm. Yes.
I
think God appreciates that too. He's a big gambler.
Yeah. Oh, Mince.
I don't even know what any of this means, though.
Doesn't matter. I don't want to talk about it. I have a whole hour I had to do with gambling, so I don't. I'd rather just move.
Kelly
on.
In Vegas is good.
She seems like the only good one.
She's not bad.
Is she on a streak?
She's the best.
She's certainly the best out of us. She's an actual, I mean, she's a real, real deal. If Barstool didn't exist, she'd still be in Vegas doing the gambling. So,
she's changed lives.
You were doing
financially.
Gambling, though, too.
I was doing gambling.
You're a real gambler.
Yeah. I am, but I got issues. Not for today.
What are they?
They're not for today. You're wearing the Shamu sweater again.
I am. It's not Shamu.
Yeah, Shamu.
That's Shamu.
Is Shamu a killer whale? Killer whales are so fucking sick.
You ever see Blackfish?
I did see, but that's Tillicum.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Tillicum was the Blackfish?
Yes. And he had the droopy fin. That's how you know they're depressed.
Yeah.
Yeah. When they have the droopy fin. I saw a crazy video the other day of some killer whales. There was a seal on a floating little iceberg.
Yeah, they'd bump it.
Yeah, or they bump it, and sometimes what they'll do is they'll go in like squads of four, and they'll create a wave.
Right.
And the wave will wash over the iceberg with the seal on it. Seal falls off. Sushi time.
Yeah,
it's fucking cool.
That's what
man.
I want to see.
Can we see that?
I want to see clips of that. I don't want to see the cast of Hamilton lip syncing Big Bong.
Yeah. Yes,
I want to see that.
Bro.
You know what I was watching? Yeah. Last night I was watching bear cubs, trying to get onto a hammock.
Oh,
and there's like hundreds of videos, and they're hysterical.
That's a frustrating video to watch because you do want the bear to get on the hammock.
No, it's really funny. And then they get angry, and they just start ripping the hammock.
Well, I think we got our next 20 minutes
that's
of videos.
That's what I
want to
see.
Out.
I don't want to see Doja Cat lip syncing Fuck Your Life.
Yeah, dude. I'm glad. Did you not fuck with Hamilton? Because I didn't.
I never got a ticket.
I only got like, well,
so
no,
it's
on Disney. It's on Disney Plus.
I would only see it live if I had the opportunity.
It was almost like too good. It like freaked me out.
There is an element where it's a little too good. I see. I only watched it once.
I've only seen.
There's an element when it's a little too good.
A little too good. You're like,
what does that mean? No, I've never had that problem.
You know who the biggest Hamilton guy is in this office?
Robbie Fox.
No.
Well, he said it like Lin-Manuel Miranda.
Big T. Big T.
Big T. I went.
He's a Hamilton guy.
Huge Hamilton. Wait, I went.
What?
I went to the College World Series with Big T. We're sitting there. There's two girls in front of us. By the third inning, these two girls are turned around, sitting.
What?
And they're just going over their favorite Hamilton songs. Big T is the biggest Hamilton fan.
I don't think that's that surprising.
He loves theater.
He is a huge Hamilton.
That is.
He can
surprising.
Name every song, every lyric of Hamilton.
All like, a bunch of musicals too. He loves Broadway.
I've never.
Yeah,
he turns from a just a useless Southern lummox into like a cultured dude talking about Hamilton. He will go. He'll tell you the virtues of the songs. He'll tell you where they came. It's incredible.
I would love to hear him talk like Phantom of the Opera.
I want him to sing.
You'll get him in here.
I think like, he was big on like Dear Evan Hansen.
I was just
gonna
say Dear Evan Hansen. Can he come sing Waving Through a Window?
Does he sing
Evan
the songs?
You
know,
yeah, he absolutely does. Because
I've heard him sing
yes,
it before.
Yes, get him in here.
And it's very good.
Get Big T in here. We want to talk Hamilton songs with him. We can watch the Bear video until Big T gets here if you want.
They had it up. It was awesome.
This is the shorter one though. There's longer ones.
Oh,
that's awesome.
That's good.
But don't you? Isn't there a part of you that wants him to get on that hammock?
Well, that one made it, and then his brother fucked it up. That's awesome.
I feel like having a hammock out in the Bear Area is kind of a mistake in the first place.
Oh, man, there is a lot of them.
There's a lot of them. It's a frequent occurrence.
Oh, Viral Hog got on it?
Wait, you said there was an iceberg one?
Yeah, the iceberg killer whale video is really
fucking
cool.
Wasn't that on Blackfish? Didn't you see?
They may have cut to that.
All right, here we go. Just have a seat, please.
Nice jersey, Big T. Who you got? Anyone on the back of that?
What did you say? Fuck you, Rudy. Thank you, Rudy.
Philip Forsberg.
Nice. Welcome, Big T. The reason you have been summoned today is we talked about Hamilton and our thoughts about it, and I said, in my experience, the biggest Hamilton guy in this office is Big T. That not only can you sing every song, you know the lyrics to every song, and you love them all. Yes.
That's mostly accurate, yes.
What's mostly accurate about it?
I don't know the words to every song. Probably three quarters.
But you're passionate about like Broadway and
no, just Hamilton.
Just
Dear Evan Hansen.
Huh?
We both like Dear Evan Hansen.
Yeah, Dear Evan Hansen too. That's true. But see, Hamilton's ruined now because poor people can watch it.
Oh, because it's on Disney Plus.
Yeah, like it's not.
When did
it's
you
not
first
cool
see
anymore.
It? Did you see it?
I
live?
Saw it in Atlanta when the first national tour they did.
And you fell in love with it immediately?
Well, I liked it before then. Like I knew all the songs and shit, but I saw it in Atlanta, and then I saw it when I moved here, and now it's on Disney, and just everybody can watch it. So it's not cool anymore. It used to be cool if you'd seen Hamilton,
right?
And now everybody's like, oh, I just watch
then
it.
Then the band blew up, and now
didn't
it's not
Stu
cool.
and Erica go together?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I feel like a bunch of people have seen it. I've never seen
it. It's the most popular play that no one has seen live.
Have you guys ever seen Wicked?
No.
I've not seen a play yet.
I've seen
never
Wicked.
Seen Cats.
The only Broadway show I've seen is Avenue Q. And it was pretty fucking good. It's the Muppets, but they rap.
Oh, I would see that.
There's some rapping ass Muppets.
I saw Raven Simone in the Sister Act.
I would see that as well.
That was good. Yes.
It's fun. I mean, it's cool. I like it.
For what it sounded like. What it costs. Like, I saw Book of Mormon, and I was like, I'd rather be watching a movie.
Yeah, no.
Really?
Like, the post.
I don't think they're very enjoyable, unless the songs are, like, really good.
Have you seen Hamilton live in New York?
Yeah, I saw it when I moved here.
What's your favorite song from Hamilton?
Wait For It, probably.
Okay, well, you have to give us a ditty.
Give us a couple bars of it?
No, I'm not.
Do you, like, that. Listen to
just
it?
Just a little bit of it.
Give no. us a hook.
Why not?
No.
Don't be Big T. Be cool, Big T, for a second. Don't be this guy.
I'm not I can't sing it right now.
You're one of the best singers in the office. Just give us a couple.
Connor.
I can't.
You actually
be
have a cue where you have a rasp.
Be Connor, not Big T.
I can't.
Come on.
I can't do it.
You're the worst.
Will you record it singing and then send it to us and we can listen to it?
Probably not, but possibly.
We've got you in the yak. The mic in front of you. Go ahead. Give us a couple, a little bit.
Can't do it.
I hate you
so much. What's the name of the song?
Wait For It.
Wait For It.
I'm going to look up the lyrics.
What if one of us sings it poorly and then you have to correct us?
What was that? I was singing it. You weren't listening.
Wait For It.
Theodosia.
Close your eyes.
Theodosia.
Theodosia writes me a letter every day. Is that how it goes?
No.
It's a different one.
How does it go? Enlighten me.
You'd have to. No.
Connor, what about Waving Through a Window?
I do love Waving Through a Window.
Come on. We've sang that before.
Have we?
Yeah, we were skipping around like 6th Avenue.
Yeah.
I don't remember that.
Yeah. It was like my first month here.
I do not recall that at all.
Oh, I'd love to see
waving
that.
Waving through a window. Try to speak, but nobody can hear. So I wait around for an answer to appear.
That was great.
That's beautiful. Thank you very much for doing that. That's awesome.
You have a nice voice, Big T.
Thanks, just got a great voice. Did you ever hear from those girls that you talked Hamilton to for eight goddamn innings at the College World Series?
No, they were so hot, dude. You know what the problem was?
I believe you know what the thing was, too?
I shouldn't say this. I can't tell that story.
Yeah, you can. I've already told most of it.
On the air?
Yeah, well, all I said was you and I were sitting and watching a baseball game.
So this is the championship?
No, this was – I don't know which game this was.
It was the middle of the College
World Series. We'd been there like 6 or 7 days. Me and him were at our peak of friendship, and we're sitting together, and these two girls sit in front of us, and I don't think anything about it. And I watch an inning, and before I know it, the two girls are sitting around. You know how
are they fans of what – what school are they coming from?
I don't remember that.
I think they just lived in Nebraska.
Yeah.
They were Creighton people.
Creighton,
I thought they were University of Nebraska. One or the other.
But anyway, they were just there. They were townies. And they ended up talking to him, and they didn't shut the fuck up for eight innings, and it was ridiculous.
They never watched a baseball game.
They were both hot.
They just watched it. He could have fucked them.
What they look
like? I believe that.
Spitting game.
I don't think I could have. I thought for a second maybe, but then no.
So you're also misremembering. They weren't both hot. They were one
I thought
one was hot, one was the hot girl's friend.
Okay. Well, one of them was very hot. I thought it was both, but
nah, they probably were both good looking.
And one girl also had a brother there. Like they were
it was a weird dynamic.
Yeah.
It was a weird dynamic for sure.
But he got in on the in the Hamilton conversation.
But you can't talk Hamilton for eight innings straight.
Oh, you absolutely can.
Well, no. Let me finish. You can't do that and then just part ways without
That's what happened. That's what happened.
That is a lot.
The bars closed at 2-0.
No numbers.
What does that mean? When did the game
end? That was the other thing. That game started at like 10:30 p.m. So it didn't end until like 1:30.
Oh, also, I mean,
that's even a better reason to not park.
You're kind of acting a little too cool for school. You were checking your Instagram for like the next hour or two after that, hoping you were catching a DM from one of them.
I don't recall
that.
That was a different girl though.
Jesus,
that wasn't
what the fuck happened.
Omaha was a movie.
He was running pussy in Omaha.
God damn.
Omaha was fun for sure.
He's a sourpuss. He's just a sour person.
That's not true.
I never said
guy.
That. I never but, even thought true. That. Yeah.
We went out one night, the night Mississippi State beat Virginia.
I think he's like a young you.
We all went to a club.
Ways.
We went to a club. Not
sorry
a club,
to both of
it's
you.
It's an outdoor club.
It was like a rave they had like outside.
What
fuck? And he just turned, I mean, he was just bouncing up and down, doing the whole thing, going and buying beer. Just the biggest dude bro of all time.
Hell yeah.
Being a dude bro, yeah.
I save it up. Like these kids, they go out every night. I'm like, I can't do that. I save it up every 3, 4, 5 weeks, and then you get one really good night out of
it. You go 0 or 100.
Correct.
Yeah. Like Rumspringa.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Damn, sounds fun, dude. I wish I could talk Hamilton.
Well, you can stay if you'd like. Oh, there he is.
It's a party in the USA. That's not even the best one.
No,
go find.
Jeez, what is this?
Close.
This is an Omaha?
You got to find
like
the
in
one.
In the fan fest.
This is right outside.
Awesome.
This is right outside the stadium.
It looks like spring break.
It was awesome.
In Omaha for this event, they have like bars and clubs all around the stadium. They only get to like party for 2 weeks out of the year.
So
but for 2 weeks,
event.
it's
they
like
go hard.
Yeah.
TJ, I don't know where you found that, but can you find the one that's it's me and you?
That's right, TJ. Oh, the girl grinding on TJ.
No, well, not there is that one, but the one I'm talking about TJ. Is it's just me and TJ going fucking bananas, and then it's you and Marty looking around like what the fuck.
There
going
absolutely
on?
Is a video of a girl grinding on TJ.
There is. I have it on my phone.
I would love to see.
Not well, TJ. It exists.
Not well.
What do you mean not well?
Does it exist?
Who was unwell?
Yeah. How do you grind poorly?
Who was grinding? Yeah, you can.
No, said,
trust me, you can. But
no, TJ said well, and I said not well. No, the well doesn't work there. If you any evidence of that you can find, and she was.
I don't know if that's public.
It's out. It's.
I don't
public.
Think that was posted, but I have.
It was it not? You haven't?
Oh yeah.
Somebody's got it. Oh, is that just between us? Did we internally share that? Okay.
Probably.
All right.
But it is awesome.
Grinding is just awesome in general.
Take a look at that, Rudy.
Yeah, it's fun.
Yeah. They're.
My God, she's hot.
Oh. Yeah, she's very hot.
Where is this?
This is almost. This was pass the phone down a second.
Oh, my God. TJ.
She. I don't
TJ,
know.
Let
we
the
can't
Phoenix
tell
boys
the whole story.
Yeah, the Phoenix boys are fiending for something, dude.
Wow.
Just put that up. We want to pass it down to the boys.
Shout
here.
Out TJ. Rocking, dude. Yeah, grinding rocks. Did you guys ever do the thing in like young, like middle school or high school dances where you would have like a grind line of just like a row of people grinding?
Certainly didn't have
no.
In a
and
single
you got a bunch
file,
of boys watching
no,
too.
Were crude.
In a single file line. That's wow. When America was right.
Just grinding is great because it always happens to you. You don't instigate it at all. It's you just look down. Oh shit! Okay, this is happening.
It's a very passive exercise.
You don't have to touch a video that much.
Yeah, KB's had my phone for too long. I don't.
I've never had.
He just got an
iPhone like this.
He just got.
Yeah,
it.
She's very attractive.
Let me see.
Had a boy
What's
teach.
Her?
KB, pass it this way.
Slap me her math.
I like that. I never heard that. That's a good one. Yeah. You should use that.
I did. I did in 2013.
So this was in Omaha?
Slap me your math.
Slap me your math.
That little like rave deal they had outside the stadium
so
every night.
There's like a crowd of dudes
outraging.
Watching.
That's what I'm saying. Everyone's just like, yeah.
No, I mean, every
Get
night.
It, TJ.
Every night after the last game, the fucking bars would have that outdoor shit going on.
Omaha's rocking, man.
Omaha was fucking.
Omaha for that week is some of the most fun I've ever had.
That's what you need. Like a city that's like. On a grand scale, boring.
Yes, right. Like it's
to have
that
one
thing.
Event, like
yes.
Indianapolis for the Indy 500.
Yeah.
Like
yeah,
cities like that.
Uh huh.
We should take a group trip. Look, do the Yak from Omaha.
Yeah, Bristol is probably like that.
Bristol, yeah.
I don't know.
Daytona. Daytona's
yeah,
not
no,
a great town.
Yeah, that was a bad example.
No, that's fake news. Daytona rocks.
No, it doesn't.
No, that's fake news.
The only thing about Daytona is you can drive on the beach. That's it.
Still.
Band shell,
cool, though.
Yeah, Fox.
What does?
Fox?
The band shell.
Yeah, you can drive on the beach.
What's
in
the
most
What's
places,
the little
yeah.
mall
no,
outdoor
no, no,
mall
no, no,
area
no.
they have
not
next
like,
to the band shell? What's that called?
Tanger Outlets
no.
in Massachusetts.
No,
Massachusetts maybe, but in Florida, and
there's some
Daytona's
places
very
in
rare.
It's called the drive on.
Yeah,
and you just drive your car right on.
I don't think that's typical of the United States. I think most beaches you cannot drive on.
Yeah.
Yeah. No.
But I'm saying there's places other than
yeah
where I grew up they have to drive on.
Daytona, though, it's like the sand isn't sandy.
That's dirt.
It's like concrete.
I did hear that.
Yeah, it's not great sand.
It's no Clearwater, but it's a nice town.
Clearwater's your example of a nice town?
Clearwater is my favorite beach.
What?
Clearwater, Florida's your favorite beach? I mean, yeah. It's fine. It's a fine beach. It's a fine beach.
A lot of sharks there.
I went to...
Oh, I don't go in the ocean. Don't get it twisted. I just enjoy the beach vibe and the sand part of the beach and the beach town. I don't go in the ocean.
The beach. I went there for I went
That's
there for New Year's.
Part. Yeah,
I went there for New Year's last year.
Which Clear, one?
Clearwater.
Did you like it?
Yeah. I did. Yeah.
I was
knew
there for
nothing.
New Year's a couple years ago.
I knew nothing about it, and I didn't have the funds to go to Miami, so it was Clearwater.
Yeah.
My
I was,
personal
I was,
favorite beach is Jersey Shore. Those beaches are beautiful.
Yeah.
Great
you,
waves.
In the Jersey Shore, didn't you pretend to tackle waves for a few hours?
That's every time I'm in
yeah,
water
that's
with
so
waves.
Fun.
But
dude,
yeah,
I do
Jersey
that
Shore
too.
Has good waves, and I love when they pulverize me. Yeah.
I like doing the thing where you run up on the waves, and then it's like you're jumping over the line, like with like you're a running back.
Yeah.
That never gets old. I love doing that. Or just like laying on your back, and then you get pushed up on the sand, and then it sucks you into the undertow.
If you jump with the wave, it like lifts you like maybe an extra half inch,
yeah,
but it feels like
you
you're
float
10
a little
feet
bit.
In the air.
God. I can
and
use
you feel
that
a
right
little
now.
Fin on your feet.
Yeah.
Why are you 100% against getting in the ocean?
There's shit in there I just don't fuck with.
Me too. Out of sight, out of mind.
But
I
like
bliss. I hate octopi.
Agreed.
Shark,
no
burning
sharks.
Passion. I'm disgusted by them.
Why? Because they're so smart.
That doesn't help. But no, they're gross.
No, I respect.
I don't
them.
Like
I love
appendages.
Octopi.
Have you ever been in the water and had like a fish like rub up against your leg?
Oh yeah,
haunting.
Yeah, so uncomfortable.
I don't like an animal that can lose an arm or a leg and be fine. That needs to be crippling.
Yeah,
yeah.
I really think that should be crippling for all animals.
Should, yeah,
they have more neurons than a human brain.
Why do you know that?
I watched that documentary. My octopus teacher. Yeah.
Your octopus teacher?
No, it's called My Octopus Teacher, the documentary.
I thought you had took an octopus.
This dude has like this like really insane obsession with this one octopus. It's a fire documentary though.
And that's his octopus teacher?
Yeah. It does have like a weird like that name has like a weird.
Does he fall in love with the octopus at all?
No, but you always wonder the whole time. You're like, is this dude going to fuck this octopus? Yeah.
What would be the best starfish obviously, but other than a starfish.
No, manatees. It's known. Manatees.
Manatees?
Used to get fucked by sailors because they have the most, their vaginas are similar to human vaginas.
That's where mermaids come from. It was just dudes fucking manatees.
Yeah. Sailors are the
Why are you both on the same
profession.
Team with
me? It's just history.
Really?
Yeah. I've heard that as well.
Yeah, sailors. No. They were like, oh, no, it was a fish woman. Yeah. No, it was just a manatee that you were fucking.
Yeah. Yeah, sailors were shooting up the club inside manatees, for real. Yeah. It's history, man. It's written.
Sailors have a high homosexuality.
I think they're the gayest profession per capita in human history.
Really?
Huh.
Sailors?
Yeah, I don't know.
I mean, it kind of would be. You're on a boat with a bunch of dudes.
Hostesses, probably.
Yeah.
Nah, that's the misconception.
Right. A lot of them are straight as an arrow.
Does that include like the Navy?
The Navy isn't that gay.
I would say
I guess the Navy isn't
never has been.
Lyft drivers in Colorado are very
talking
gay.
About?
Really?
Yeah, but mostly
just Lyft or Uber and Lyft.
You think
Uber and Lyft, but like in Colorado when Lyft
Navy isn't gay. Why would you even bring that up?
I mean, they're
the
sailors.
SEALs?
I don't think the Navy's no. I think that a lot of them are gay.
Jesus. The Navy?
I mean, I have no facts to argue with them. But yeah, no, in Colorado, a lot of the...
I have no facts to support that.
Yeah, the Uber drivers in Colorado, when the Uber first started popping off, they were almost exclusively lesbians.
Really?
Yeah. A lot of lesbians.
And why is that?
I don't know. I think there's just a lot of lesbians in Colorado. Hmm. It's a lesbian-friendly place.
Yeah, a lot of Subarus.
So many Subarus, dude. Girls with, you know, like Skrillex hair in a Subaru picking you up to go
yes.
to...
Yes.
Dude, the worst Uber driver is just like a white guy your dad's age.
Yes. The worst, because
they're doing it for fun, and they want conversation.
100%.
Like,
100%.
Whatever happened for a small period of time, there was a button you could push that says, don't talk to me, and now it doesn't exist anymore.
Yeah. Well, New York, they just
New
don't
York
talk to
New York is the best. It's like a Pakistani guy who's like whispering on Bluetooth to somebody.
Anytime you go
doesn't
out
sound
of...
like they could ever hear each other, but that's ideal.
They're just riffing the whole time, dude.
At
it's like
the
a podcast.
Lowest decibel.
So quiet.
It doesn't sound like a human conversation.
Doesn't sound like voices actually coming out.
No. It's the oddest thing.
Yeah.
I had one,
but that's what I want.
I'd like to hear more about lesbians in Colorado.
I mean, I don't really have much else to tell you other than a lot of them were Lyft drivers. I don't know what they're doing now.
I've always wanted to start out in Colorado like a combination dating hiking app for lesbians, but I don't know what to call it.
Oh,
is this like a trick question? Rhetorical.
I mean, I feel like that would definitely take off.
Just dating plus hiking.
Just call it dyke.
Huh?
You just call it dyke. Hike, dyke.
Dyke is, I feel like that's not okay to use.
Yeah, that wasn't cool, Rudy.
Is that derogatory?
That was, okay.
You can't say that.
Just one fucking time on the act and you say that?
You just set me up for that.
You got this show.
You're kind of a cunt for that.
Yeah. Oh, I got this. Oh, okay. Yeah.
Damn.
Come from KB. That's rich.
God damn it, Rudy.
That app would take off, though.
Yeah, I think probably it would.
I mean, dude, a farmer's friend.
They wouldn't even let that thing in the app store.
Dude, please. If they let Christian Mingle exists, that's way weirder.
What's Kate walking with? Kate, what is that?
Looks like an upside down Sicilian.
Oh yeah, she likes to go to Bravo across the street.
Good shit,
really good.
Looked delicious.
Yeah.
Who's that? At an Uber, we drove by. There must have been somebody like A-list celebrity famous because there was like 250 people trying to take a picture of him.
Yeah, come on.
And then my Uber driver's like,
"We got an empty seat too.
Whoever he is, he's just like me."
Really?
I was like, what? He's like, whoever he is just like me and you. And that was good. That was fun.
Okay, well.
Yeah.
A text from who? Owen.
Say it on the mic.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
We ran out of chairs before you got here.
I got a text from Owen.
You're subbing in.
Oh, I'm sorry. Big T's gone. He was not comfortable here anyway. Yeah. Trust me. He was... Yeah.
He didn't want to be here anymore.
He is the miserable fucking cunt.
No, he was great today.
He was a great man.
You can only get like 10 good minutes out of him though before he...
He was all things. He was fine.
I thought he was delightful.
Yeah.
And I need to carry my phone around more often. I never see it when people text me. So sorry about that.
That's fine. You were just standing there and you had the new merch on. So
oh,
I
yes.
said if you wanted to show the new merch.
Camera's not even on me right now.
No, we'll get it.
That's cool. Not obsessed.
Yeah, thank you.
How do you get it?
What's cool?
Wait, here's a sweatshirt.
Is that yours?
Yes.
Oh, that's awesome.
And then I got sweatpants. And then I also have a gray hoodie as well that matches the sweatpants. It was revealed today. It goes live on Monday at 10 a.m. at the Barstool store. Or you can follow me on Instagram.
What should people who want it do right now?
What?
What should people who want it do?
Wait.
Wait till Monday at 10 a.m.
Is there a wait list?
Kate, do you have any new Ragged Housewife merch or anything?
Nope, just the same old shit.
Okay.
Getting pizza everywhere. Thank you for having me.
You're welcome.
saucy seat.
Oh, Sass, why don't you ask her the thing you said earlier about the sailors? She may know if it's true or not.
Yeah. Oh, it's true. She's military.
What did I say?
He said the Navy is like a predominantly gay field.
He said the Navy's gay.
I did not say I said like the Navy. I said, does that include the Navy? Because you're saying that sailors are gay.
Is that a bad... Are you saying that's a bad thing?
No, he's just curious.
He's just asking. He's just asking.
He's just curious.
But yes, absolutely.
They Navy's are? Gay?
For sure,
for They're
sure.
They're the gayest of the four service.
I think so.
I feel like I heard that before.
They wear an
all-white dress uniform.
No, true.
I agree
with that.
With a gold buckle.
Yeah.
So.
But becoming a SEAL. I guess that, yeah. No.
Yeah.
Underwater shit is...
It requires holding your breath for a long
gay,
time.
Right?
Oh, it's so hard.
I couldn't do any of it.
Me neither,
Donnie is going this weekend to hang out with the Navy SEALs on Coronado Island.
It's always fucking
I don't know if I'm allowed to say that.
Donnie, always fucking
which Donnie?
Chef Donnie.
Hippo mode, probably, if I had to guess.
He swam across the East River, and now he thinks he could be a SEAL.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
No, the other Donnie, and he's like actually going to the spot where they train.
So, Chef Donnie.
Yes.
Well, you said Hippo mode, Donnie.
I know, but because Hippo mode, he's a water guy SEAL.
Yeah. I think Chef Donnie could probably do it.
Oh, probably. I think he could, too.
Yeah, I think
do
so.
Do what?
The SEAL, or at least
become a SEAL.
Do a reasonable facsimile of what they go through the training. At least not embarrass himself when he tries.
Like a mini version.
Yeah.
I think he's mentally very tough. I think that's the hardest part is the mental.
Yeah.
I think he could do it.
What was the hardest thing you've ever done?
No, it's not as hard as you think. That's a secret.
But what was like the most difficult?
Besides, you know, don't bury in your friend.
Don't. Oh.
Right? Yeah. Besides the dead. Besides all the dead friends.
Right. That would suck.
That's probably number one. Okay. Number two is probably hikes. Yeah. Dead friends, hikes,
dead
cleaning.
Friend. Okay.
That's probably the order.
Jeez.
Yeah. Anyways, thanks guys.
Enjoy your pizza.
All right, okay.
See you, Kate.
Thank you.
This was nice. That was nice.
Do you guys want me to stay? Go. I don't want to impose.
No, you stay. You stay.
Okay.
You're good.
Have you ever buried friends?
What?
How many?
Have you ever buried a friend? Is that what you just asked
me? That was going to be the next subject that we were going to go around.
No, I've not lost a friend. I've only actually lost one person in my life, so I've been very blessed. And it was a grandparent, so, I mean, it wasn't out of the blue.
Mm. It's comforting.
Ugh.
Sans, you
very
might,
depressing
you might
conversation. Jesus.
Yeah.
Dark Ugh. Room.
Yeah.
Oh, well, Mugsy. not really.
So Mugsies are the most comfortable men's jeans on the planet. I am wearing my Mugsies today, and look how comfortable I am. Built with a proprietary stretch denim, these jeans look stylish but feel like you're wearing sweatpants. One Mugsy customer says, I used to hate jeans, now I don't. I agree. These don't feel like jeans at all. They feel like absolute sweatpants. They're comfortable as hell. They're my Friday clothes because I like to dress comfortably on Friday. They're perfect gift for the friend or man in your life who could use a little comfort pick-me-up. Same dudes that brought us the world's most comfortable jeans are also your one-stop shop for chinos, shorts, tees, and hoodies. Give the gift of comfort this holiday season with Mugsy Jeans and use code YAK for $10 off your order at MugsyJeans.com. Where else, boys?
The whole chat wants Sass to address the chicken fry video.
Sass, if you could...
I don't, like, understand.
What is this?
Oh, yeah, I saw that this morning.
It's like there's been, like, 15 of them.
What is this?
TJ, if you could show us the chicken fry video in question. Thank you.
O'Malley's taking my spot on Son of a
Boy. I was just thinking about the call that I got from Erica and Dave. It was on a live stream on Facebook Live, and they were like, we need O'Malley to replace Lil Sass on Son of a Boy Dad. And I was like, what are you guys talking about? What do you mean, dude? Like, Sass is phenomenal. He loves Bob Dylan. He's such an old soul. And I was like, dude, O'Malley cannot replace that. No, and they were like, no, Gaz, specifically Gaz.
Gaz.
Yeah, no, Gaz hopped in. He called in, he dialed in, and he was like, O'Malley needs to be the second chair with Roan on Son of a Boy Dead. Mm-hmm. And I was like, dude, like, guys, I hired O'Malley to work with me. Personally. And then...
Through nepotism.
Yes, and what does your hat say?
Viva! Viva! Yeah. Viva! Viva!
Viva!
Viva! Fagerstein. That trio has been...
It's a quad.
A quad with Fagerstein.
Fagerstein.
They've been like doing like some avant-garde style of trolling us for a while now.
Yeah, they keep and coming after me. Working. I don't know why.
Especially you.
Yeah, it's funny. I like it.
Are you taken aback by it?
Yeah.
No, I was just like confused. And then people like for some reason believed it, which was the craziest part about it.
I did believe it.
I did
was
too.
Was it not supposed to be believed?
No.
You really thought that video was like serious?
I don't know. I just saw it for the first time. Didn't really form an opinion until now.
No.
O'Malley. I think she'd do great. I think I'd be worried, Sass.
Yeah.
What were all the markings on her?
Looks like tattoos.
That was like her tribal, her like cult thing. The smiley face. Yeah. Yeah, it's like a smiley face, but the eyes are
dead X's. Smiley.
Sleep dead when you're smiley. Dead. Yeah. Sleep when you're dead.
Those things over there?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, those ones right there. Yeah.
People get it tattooed on them.
Yeah. People were getting that tattooed long before.
Those
then,
things
though.
Right there make more money than I will ever see in my entire life.
Yeah, correct. Ever. In 1 month.
I might just leave.
Yeah. It's funny. I actually almost got a tattoo of that exact thing, but years and years ago.
Why?
I don't know. It was just like, I don't know.
So there was the, like, 2011 was, like, the big era where
I think
sleeping, like, not sleeping was the,
was
the
tight.
Trend. Like,
yeah. Fuck sleep.
For, like, music people and athletes.
Yeah.
Remember the video where the black guy's narrating it, and he was like, "If you want to,
if you want to succeed
as
more
bad
than
as
you want to
breathe, then
and only
be
then
successful.
Will you be successful."
I remember seeing that
was
video.
Like Beyonce, he was talking about
Thomas,
like 50 yeah. Cent, and he was two weeks straight, not a single second of sleep, and that's how you're successful.
He also never touched the field.
And it was like a East Carolina football player doing like ladder drills on the beach.
Yeah. Dude, that was also the same time in like on Instagram where I
but
feel like
worked.
Ladder drills
no,
on beaches.
Yeah. So like our like obscure like Mac wrestling team was like waking up at 4 to do like
two a days
to do drills on the mat, and we were like, this is detrimental to us.
Yeah,
we feel like shit 24/7.
Yeah, but it's like, dude, you gotta. It was like the OG Sigma grind set. You know what I mean?
I mean, I get like being like, oh, don't sleep like 16 hours a day, but like you need to sleep.
Yeah, you
at
operate
least, like
much
5 hours.
Yeah.
I would say much more than 5.
Dude,
yeah,
I
can't. Some people can like get away with 5,
really?
Though. Like, Owen, how much do you sleep? 4?
I'm 4 a night.
How do you do that?
Oh, my God.
How do you do that?
I think your brain chemistry is different. You're built different.
Some people can just do that.
No, 8 hours of rest,
worse.
8 hours
my
of work, 8 hours
getting
of
worse.
Sleep.
If I get 7, I'm good.
Yeah, I need 7. Anything below 7, it's a bad day.
If I get 6, I'm good. If I get anywhere below 5, it's like debilitating.
I always know exactly when I need to wake up, and I aim for being asleep by 8 hours before that.
Yeah, me too.
I don't know if I could do more than 8 consecutively.
I did 10 last night.
I do like 6. I'm the 6.
You're
what?
A
mm-hmm.
You guys are freaks.
So if you got to get up at 7, you go to sleep at 1 and you're good.
Yeah, I get up at 6 every day.
What?
Damn.
No matter what time.
What?
No matter what time.
Why?
I get up.
Are you one of those that when the sun comes up,
you can't be
asleep?
No, I like can't sleep, and I can't sleep in either. It's a problem I have.
I'm just jealous of that. I wish I had
love
that.
Love sleeping. There's no better sleeping time than in the
every
morning.
Every single morning, I'm like, I'm going to wake up at 8 a.m. today.
And you don't.
And I never do. Except yesterday I did because me and Dave had a meeting and it was supposed to be in the morning and I got in at like 9 o'clock and then he got in at 12. Mm. I was like, I could have just gone with my normal schedule today.
That's a good.
Was that meeting talked about yesterday?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's a good negotiating tactic by him. Make you wait.
I know it was.
Yeah.
How's your sleeping, Kyle?
I get like 8.
Yeah.
I don't have any issues.
Standard 8.
Yeah.
Okay, but you wake up at around 8 too, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can I just talk to y'all about y'all allowing, not you guys, but you guys allowing that lion caller yesterday? That lion liar piece of shit caller?
I called him out.
Yeah, I appreciate that.
I said
what
that.
Did he say that was wrong?
I didn't think
well,
he said
well, he described
wrong.
A nice interaction with Brandon, and then he went on Twitter and
right.
shit on him.
That's what he did.
It wasn't his whole argument.
He wanted the best of both worlds where he, like, you were very nice to him. And then
I gave him 5 minutes. I was in line to get a Coke, and he came up to me. I said, okay, well, stay in line with me. And then after I get my Coke, walk over here. We'll take a picture with you. And that happened. And then I shook his hand, and I walked off. And he's like, yeah, that guy's semi-famous. I did the whole act. I was like, whoa, semi-famous. Yeah, come on, Brandon Walker.
I got that.
And I did all that. And then I shook hands again, and I walked off. And 30 seconds later on Twitter –
was it him that tweeted it?
He texted his friend saying we got an argument, and his friend added Dave and Dan saying, oh, this guy's bad vibes. He's an asshole. And I'm like,
gave
you 5 minutes. Yeah, he was a fan. I gave you 5 minutes of my – like, I gave you everything you wanted, and now he – and then he calls in. I don't know what he talked about.
I guess he didn't tweet it, but his friend did, but the messages – he only sent negative messages about
correct. Him. Yeah, he made it seem like I was an asshole. Fuck that kid. Fuck that fucking kid.
Yeah.
Yeah, no.
Hell yeah.
Just don't like people lying. That's
DC.
All.
You know, he has a Barstool lame. Tattoo on his thigh.
Yeah.
Well.
Of what? What is it?
Just the stool.
Stool and stars?
No, no stars.
It's like a blue background with just the
he
stool.
He hasn't earned them yet.
Yeah. He hasn't earned his stars. He's not a 5-star general.
He does a new star every year.
Yeah.
That would be a great thing at Barstool if we had to earn our stars. Yeah. We're like Cracker Barrel waitresses.
Yeah. Yeah.
Nothing better than sitting down at Cracker Barrel and getting a 4-star sitting over you with
would
halitosis.
You good?
Who would just be littered
just
in stars?
Oh,
shit.
My God. Who would be who'd be starred up?
Yeah.
Spider.
Spider be starred
Spider.
Up.
Spider be a 5-star general. Like George Washington.
Devlin, TGA.
Yeah, Devlin, TGA.
Would be stirred up.
Smitty would have, like, would have been up to 4 at one point, had a couple revoked.
Yeah.
Dishonorably discharged.
Oh, you're thinking up to 5 stars? I was thinking we'd cover them like a Buckeye's
helmet. Like a Buckeye's helmet.
Yeah. Well, 5 is the max in the military, but we don't have to adhere to those.
No,
rules.
I think there should be helmet stickers. I think we should get helmet stickers.
Yeah. Helmet stickers would be tight.
How many stars are on the Barstool logo? You should know it by heart.
18?
16.
Jordan, are you like sending an email, like a work more. Email?
No, I got 3 packages stolen yesterday, and I'm pissed off. And
from
I just
where?
Got a, my apartment.
That sucks.
And I just got an email saying that my package was delivered, another one. So I just texted my roommate saying, please go pick it up for me so it doesn't get stolen.
You should
it is,
get them delivered here.
It's an interesting curiosity.
Can I do that? Yeah. I'm gonna do that
because mine got stolen.
Yeah, I got $250
you have a doorman.
Worth of stuff stolen.
Stealing packages is the easiest thing in the world.
Yeah, now.
We haven't figured out a fix to it. Like, just how about just
pissed.
Don't
you ever stolen a package?
I've not stolen a package, but I did get my mother had to send me my suit from my grandmother's funeral, and I forgot it at home. She sent it to me, and it got stolen off my porch.
That's so annoying.
$1,000 suit.
I hope it had like the card from the funeral in it, so they found
it's
it.
It's also
felt like a dick.
It's a 48 extra long coat.
Yeah.
Like I don't know how many people they're gonna find.
Fuck that.
Yeah. Like I know it's the holidays and it's like extra stealing time, but
it's fun. Yeah. And sometimes you gotta play takeout roulette.
It pisses me off. All
There's
my
so many restaurants in the city that do the takeout bags on like this. Abandoned desk that no one's watching.
I know. I
and
always
sometimes
wonder.
Sometimes it's fun. Sometimes even when I place an order, I purposely take somebody else's because I'm bad at ordering.
Right.
Whenever I order with somebody else, their meal is always better. So I just take someone else's.
I have had the urge to steal somebody's lunch.
I stole someone's McDonald's. Morally, it's not stealing if you leave yours and take somebody
else's. You're
trading,
yeah.
I was walking home and there was just a bag of McDonald's on right by someone's door, and it was like still warm. But they weren't gonna get it.
How good was it?
It was really good.
What was in the order?
So much food.
What was in it?
Chicken sandwiches, McChickens, burgers, fries.
Like a buffet of food.
Oh yeah.
That was a good move, right?
Yeah, it was. It was so. I checked the thing. It was like an hour after it already arrived.
We should do theft.
What two menu?
It was ethical. I just like the sausage burrito, the breakfast burrito, and the. Filet-O-Fish.
I love a filet.
Those are two of my top.
McChicken slaps.
Yeah, the McChicken.
I never had it. If you're gonna have chicken sandwich, don't go to McDonald's.
It's rubbery.
Yeah, I don't usually do chicken.
Screams
McDonald's
food
either.
Poisoning to
no,
me.
No, Filet-O-Fish is great.
No, the Filet-O-Fish bangs.
It's square. It can't be poisoned if it's a square fish.
They also have they have scientists there whose entire job is to scientifically engineer that food to taste good. It can't taste bad.
I believe in science.
What about the McRib? Were you guys ever
really good?
I never had that.
Never had it.
I had one. I wasn't a huge fan.
Or the McGriddle.
I swear I would have ordered one.
I'll go get us.
You guys should do a mukbang of McDonald's in here sometime.
What was that challenge everyone was doing where it was like a burger, I think chicken nuggets and fries and like a medium drink. And
you had to eat
it in like under a minute or something.
Oh, yeah.
I think it was five under five. It was like five items under 5 minutes.
It might have been that. I forget exactly what it was.
There was a shorter one, like you were saying. That was like 1 minute.
Yeah.
It was like
a
small drink.
I think it's just a Happy Meal in a minute.
Yeah, I think it is.
I couldn't eat a Happy Meal in a minute.
No.
I think I could eat.
The fries are going to bog down in your...
I think the world record's under 10 seconds.
The Sprite is the most important part because that's what cleans out the pipes. You know what I'm saying? Like if you get it like right with like a carbonated drink.
Yeah, but chugging soda's hard.
Are people choking less than they did in like 1970 or more?
I don't know. I almost choked in my apartment last night.
Is that like a consistent thing that people will always do at the same rate?
That's a great question. I don't know.
I don't know if it fluctuates. I think it's probably a flat rate.
We're not getting better at
avoiding. I don't know that we're getting better or worse.
Dude, last night in my apartment, I made a sandwich and I was eating it so fast that I had to part of it got stuck like right here and I had to take 30 seconds.
That's like your stomach.
You ever had one?
That means you digested it.
Do you live alone?
It was where it needed
to
be.
Do you ever think like what would happen if you started choking?
It got stuck right here?
I would have to run out of
What do you mean it got stuck right here?
Dude,
that's never happened.
It's already down at that point.
That happens all the time.
Yeah.
How do you even know?
Because you feel like this tightness and you feel like you're about to like die. It's the worst feeling ever.
You're not choking. You can still breathe fine, but there's a blockage because it's just you went too hard.
Have you ever had something stick in your throat and you had that moment or a second where you're like, oh, this?
Yeah.
I've never had that, thank God.
Or like if you're taking like medication and all of a sudden it gets stuck and you feel like you're going to throw up.
Yeah.
You guys?
No, I've never had that. Have you ever had a choking scare?
Mentally,
I had a choking scare.
Yeah. When I say medication, I mean like magnesium. Yeah.
Oh, this guy's gonna eat the whole Happy Meal and Jesus.
Looking.
Why would you do that?
Was that all the fries he just whacked?
Oh God.
I like how he has a headband on. He's all.
This is Matt Stoney. He's the only guy to win the hot dog contest during Joey Chestnut's reign.
Oh, he won it?
He won it 1 year.
So he's like a
leader. He ate that in 19 seconds.
Yeah, I feel like that'd be easy.
No, it wouldn't be easy.
Dude.
No, he's the best
in a whole minute.
He's the best in the world.
It's like watching LeBron play basketball and say, oh, I could have done that.
That would not be easy.
I'm not saying in 19 seconds, but I could do that in a minute.
You just watched Picasso paint.
I don't think you could.
I think you could do it in two.
I could do it in a minute, I swear.
Happy meal in a minute.
We need a Happy Meal.
I think I could do it in a minute, too.
You guys should try doing that.
You want me to order Happy Meals?
No, a minute goes faster than you think. What's in a Happy Meal? A cheeseburger,
fries,
cheeseburger, fries,
drink.
No way. No fucking way. Not even three.
We can bring you in Monday and let you do it.
Like I feel like I could do it in 3 minutes.
Plenty of people did
it in a long time.
No, you can't.
I do it.
Tons of people did it in a minute.
Yeah.
I don't know the standards. Okay, maybe you could.
3 minutes is a long time.
But it's only 1 minute.
I thought you were saying you could do it in three.
Oh, I could do it. I think I could do it in 1 minute. I think I could. I can eat fast.
Shouldn't take you longer than 5 minutes to eat a Happy Meal.
McDonald's
in general, you shouldn't be relaxing eating McDonald's. Yeah. Like
when you're
McDonald's,
you are
earned.
Powering it down.
Yeah, exactly.
You should get it down as fast as you can.
Yeah. I mean, I was doing it for sport last night. I did it I was just eating quickly just because I couldn't help myself.
For sport. Yeah. I like saying things for sport.
Yeah, I was eating my sandwich with ferocity for sport. Yeah.
Yeah. That's crazy about the Navy
you guys
being gay, though.
Are you going to watch Rough and Rowdy?
Now I'm thinking about Annapolis, the Maryland flag, that whole vibe.
That whole vibe, that mid-Atlantic vibe.
Just being in a bay, really.
Mid-Atlantic is...
Yeah.
The gayest region.
Crab cakes are not a very heterosexual food.
You're sucking on it and everything.
Delaware.
And the Navy is gay.
What is it? The Navy's gay.
Oh, man. I'm from the Air Force land.
You are.
We're Air Force out in Colorado.
Air Force is sick.
Yeah, Navy's going to be here tomorrow. Army Navy's at
MetLife. You guys,
when
is the last time the Air Force Academy has done anything in athletics?
Their hockey team made it to the Elite Eight 5 or 6 years ago, but that's about it.
Does Air Force have a good hockey
team?
They're
okay at lacrosse.
Don't they all have like good sports? Like West Point?
No.
They're always pretty subpar.
They have a lot of gusto, though. They play with a lot of oomph.
Yeah.
I love the Citadel.
Zero skill, but a lot of oomph. Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. The football team isn't
that
great.
Have they ever won like a – what's the best a service academy has done in NCAA football?
Oh, well, if you go back in history, though, like they used to get the best – like Army has Heisman winners back in the 40s. And then got national titles back
like
in the
40s. What about like since 1970?
Nothing. Maybe a 9-2 season, a 10-1 season, something like that, but never on a national scale winning anything important.
The Army-Navy games?
Navy does have the all-time – their quarterback set the record for all-time rushing touchdowns a couple years ago, so they got an all-time record. Keenan Reynolds.
Those games would be a lot cooler if, like, Army Navy. For just those games.
for this makes it crazy.
For just those games, Army Navy, they should be allowed to use like non-lethal military equipment, like flashbangs.
Oh, we were just talking about flashbangs are no joke. College Fest 2012. That was one of the most bone-chilling moments of my life.
I still couldn't tell if you were kidding.
Dude, I got I believe you because I got secondhand mace, and it was like I was dying.
Some of the people in the video looked like they were going to refer to that as a bone chilling moment.
I'm like joking, but at the time I was like, we were like all like we couldn't stop talking about how bone chilling it was. We like didn't sleep for 2 days. Like,
somebody was smoking mace around you.
You guys thought you were like
I was at a bar.
Yeah, they're throwing flashbangs at us. We were rendered blind.
Dude, I always want to know how like how much a flashbang in real life compares to, like in Call of Duty.
Oh, I'm sure it's pretty awful. I think
Call of Duty, it's like you just get just goes white for like 10 seconds.
Yeah, and you're like, I'm flashed. He's flanking. He's pushing.
It's probably
pushing.
Worse on Call of Duty than it is in real life.
Yeah, for sure is. For sure is.
Just can't imagine dealing with that. Oh, there's my Chick-fil-A. Boy, that was time beautiful.
You should
that
see it if so you could good. Have it before the act ends. 3 minutes and 30 seconds.
No, I'm going to savor my Chick-fil-A because I got a sweet tea.
Eat it slow.
That sounds so good.
Yeah, I know.
Nice and slow.
They got good sweet tea at the Chick-fil-A in Manhattan.
That sweet tea.
All right, Kyle, you got anything to plug?
Rough and Rowdy tonight, boys.
Rough and Rowdy.
The also, speaking of Army-Navy, Barstool Sportsbook, please, if you have never deposited, you can sign up. Deposit $100, and we give $100 to Fisher House Charity. For
there we go.
There you go.
Very cool.
It's great. Viva la Troops.
Viva la Troops.
All right, cool. You guys good?
Let's run it.
Let's get out of here. Jordan, thank you for being here. Rudy.
Thank you for having me.
It was awesome. All right, that's the Yak.
That hour goes by fast.
He's on.
Any hot mic?
Bye.